Okay, so somebody asked me to review Highlander the Source. And I've kind of got this terrible habit of saying that I'm going to follow up and review something, usually when I've done like a one review I picked out or a series of them, and I never do follow up on it. And this kind of helped me get back on track to go ahead and finish out talking what I had left to say about the rest of the Highlander movies and the series that kind of spun out. This movie obviously is one of the worst out of the series. I mean, two is better than that, and that's a pretty bad scenario if you got to say that. There's a lot of things I could say in this review. Personally, I think Holy Diver, who did a review on Highlander the Source, is a very funny skit. If you see that, go check it out because it's a lot funnier than what I could say, and it informs you better. But yeah, Highlander the Source is just bad. Now, originally, I saw this the night that it premiered on Sci-Fi, and this was back in like maybe 07, I think it was when it came out. And it's actually not even over an hour long, which is kind of bad. The whole premise of this is that Duncan has become completely disillusioned with the game and has kind of taken himself out of it. And the world has fallen into chaos somehow, like much more so worse than what the world was in Highlander 2, which, by the way, this is not a sequel to that. This just goes back to how complicated the movies are and the fact that the series never could focus on the two or three different continuities that it set up. Because, like, this movie falls in, like, this falls in the continuity where the first movie took place, followed by the series and Endgame. So this is supposed to take place some time long after Endgame. We don't know what happened to Kate from that movie, just the fact that she was killed at some point, we don't know when. And she's mentioned very briefly in this movie. The whole premise is that a bunch of planets are lining up, and Mythos, along with a couple of other immortals, have been watching this for some time and saying that the source will appear. The source, which is never explained in this movie, aside from the fact that this is where a group of immortals go on kind of like this Lord of the Rings quest to find the source of all immortality, and it's the one chance to face off against the Guardian, who is the most powerful of the immortals. The Guardian in this is completely over the top, and I mean, like, there's just bad acting and bad script writing all around in this. He's a very over the top villain who looks like a wrestler dressed up in some S&M gear. The first thing that I forgot to mention about this movie too is how it completely throws out all the rules established by Highlander. Now, with all the bad movies and the spin-offs that came out of the original movie, they at least stuck to the rules. I mean, Highlander 2, even though it went completely out in left field and said that all immortals are aliens, it actually stuck to the rules that it established in the first movie, and that's why I kind of cited it as a better movie. Here, the fact that you're not supposed to fight on holy ground, the Watchers don't exist anymore in this movie. And just a lot of things are completely blown out of proportion. I mean, it's a terrible movie all around. And I'm having a hard time explaining this right now because I mean, I haven't watched it since I've seen it, but you don't exactly forget something like this. Apparently, Duncan, Mythos, and a few other immortals, along with Duncan's mortal wife, are going to the source because apparently this is the one place where the whole thing about there can be only one is surmised that only one immortal is worthy enough to step up and face the Guardian and receive the ultimate prize, which is mortality, and which all of the immortals begin experiencing that because the way this works is that the closer that you get to this one spot where the planets have aligned up, the immortals now become mortal, And I'm gonna spoil this, but it's just such a bad movie that I'm kind of rambling on about it. But the entire point of it is that Duncan winds up being the one, obviously, and his prize is fathering a child. And instead of him being the only one left, he actually lets the guardian live. And apparently, the whole point of the game was not death, but life. I'm having a hard time explaining a bad plot right here, but this is essentially what the movie amounts to. And that's pretty much it on the movies. This is the reason why that there is a remake. And this one I will talk about soon enough, which completely annihilated the franchise. So I've just sat here and explained a bad movie. And as many points as I can call on it being bad. But like I said, though, if you want to see a more informed review about this movie, go watch Holy Diver, who had his Highlander the Source review. His is much better, but this is just me expressing my feelings on this right now. And sorry, Kevin Hardy, but there's just not much more I can say about this. It's a terrible movie. Don't watch it. If you have watched it, I'm sorry. And that's all I'll say about it.